beautiful parts of a plant. They are found in different colors with different fragrances. Basically, flower contains four parts. So coming to the parts of a flower, it contains calyx or sepals, corolla or petals, andrecium or stamen, gynoecium or pistil. Sepals are the protective parts of a flower. Petals attract the insects for pollination. Andrecium is the male reproductive part of a flower. It contains anther and filament. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part of a flower. It contains ovary, style and stigma. Ovules are present in the ovary. If the flower has a stalk, also called pedicel, it is described as pedicellate flower. If it is without a stalk, then it is said to be sessile. A flower which can be cut into two exactly similar halves along any vertical plane passing through its center is said to be actinomorphic. Example, hibiscus. A flower which can be cut into two similar halves only along one vertical particular plane is said to be zygomorphic. Example, Crotalaria. A flower which contains both stamens and carpels is said to be a bisexual flower or perfect flower. A flower having either stamen or carpels are called unisexual or imperfect flower. A unisexual flower containing only the carpels is called female or the pistillate flower. A unisexual flower containing only the stamen is called the male or staminate flower. So coming to the general description of the floral part, sepals. Sepals usually green and leaf-like structures. They may be free or fused. When sepals are green in color, they perform photosynthesis. Corolla is brightly colored and scented to attract the insects for cross-pollination. Andrecium is the male reproductive organ and it consists of stamens. Stamens typically consist of a stalk called the filament with upper swollen part called the anther at the tip. So in anther, pollen grains are developed from diploid pollen mother cells. Coming to the gynoecium, it is the female reproductive organ of the flower. It is formed by one or more pistils. A single pistil may contain one or more carpels. Each carpel contains ovary, style and stigma. Coming to the ovary, it is the enlarged basal portion of the gynoecium. Ovary contains cushion-like regions called placentas which bear one or more ovules. Ovule is attached to its placenta by a stalk known as funicle. Ovule is provided with two protective coverings known as integuments. Integuments leave a small opening called micropyle at the tip of the ovule. The ovule contains an embryo sac located in the nucleus at the micropyle end. The embryo sac has three components. First one is egg apparatus containing the oosphere or female gamete and two synergids. Second one contains a central cell with two polar nuclei that latter fuse to form a single secondary nucleus. Third one contains three antipodal cells. Coming to the style, it is a stalk-like structure connecting the stigma to the ovary. It transports the pollen to the egg cell to deliver the male gametes. Coming to the stigma, it is the portion of the pistil that receives the pollen. It is commonly sticky or feathery to capture the pollen. Thank you.